Hello. So in this video, I'll be showing the features of my practical assignment. So let's get started with the steering behaviors. So first we have the seek behavior, where I can choose a point and the car will reach that point without slowing down. So after the point is reached, the car did not come to a stop, so it kind of rotates around in place around that point. I choose the point with my mouse. We have the flee behavior, which will make the blue car start fleeing from the red car, and then after it's reached a certain distance, it will go back to what it was doing previously, which was seeking to this point. We have the arrive behavior, which is very similar to seek, except the car actually stops at its destination. We have the pursue behavior, where the red car will actually see a position in the future of the blue car and seek to that. I have a follow state steering behavior, where the red car will arrive to a position that's behind the blue car. I have obstacle avoidance, so the blue car, if the red car is in its trajectory, it will go around it. And the red car also has a wander steering behavior. Where it will try to move in a direction that's on a circle projected in front of it. Sometimes it will turn left, sometimes it will turn right. Sometimes it will go straight. Next, we have the pathfinding behavior. So I'm using A star to find a path between the points. If it's a straight road, then I don't arrive. However, if I'm approaching a curve, then the car will arrive to the curve, making it easier to do without crossing the buildings as much. And now, lastly, we have the strategy behavior, which will have the blue car try to get to the passenger. But it also introduces fuel to the system, and the car will check if it has enough fuel for the journey to the passenger, and if it doesn't, it will try to get to the fuel first. Car goes to get fuel first, and then goes to pick up the passenger. If the car runs out of fuel, it's just gonna move slightly slower. The car will sometimes move over the buildings. That is not the fault of my implementation, but that's the fault of the do waypoints cross buildings function included with the framework. However, generally, it will take a correct path. And that would be all the features of my program. And thank you for watching this video.